Life has consisted of all those things you read and hear about on TV and in the news. It has been a live, lifetime movie. One of the things I've had to endure was abuse. The dictionary meaning of the word abuse is to misuse, to use improperly, to use up, or to injure by maltreatment. The effects of abuse can be devastating and long-lasting. Many people never recover from it. There are different kinds of abuse: sexual, emotional, verbal, and physical. I've experienced firsthand each one of these. No matter the form, the results are always terrible. It can keep you from functioning properly. I understand this because I was abused throughout most of my life. Here is my lifetime movie. As a child, after my parents divorced at the age of 5, I lived with my father in Ohio. He soon remarried, and during this time, I was beaten regularly by my stepmother. I remember one of my sister's beatings. It has haunted me since that day. I was looking out the window waiting for my bus, and my sister called for me to help her in the bathroom. I knew if I missed that bus, I would get the beating. However, if my sister-in-law got my stepmom, she would get the beating. I raced down the hallway, praying that bus would not come. Just as I was in the middle of helping her, I heard the honk of the bus. I left her there and ran out the door. As the door was shutting, I heard her, my stepmother, the yells of her and the lashes she was beginning to give my baby sister as she cried out for me. I kept going and I ran after that bus, sat in my seat and looked out the window and cried all the way to school with my sister's screams lasting in my ears. I also remember my last beating. I stood on my stool when I washed the dishes and then I went into my room. Apparently I did not get a knife clean because there was remnants of cheese still on it. The consequences was a beating with a flip-flop. My father found the bruises the very next day and asked, "Where did you get these from?" pointing to them. I simply replied, "I don't know." A few weeks later, I went to visit my mother in Rocky Mount, who notably still lives there. When I went back to my dad's, my stepmom was gone. The nightmare of living in constant fear was finally over. After that, my dad was divorced 3 times before I was even a teenager. Then he came out as being gay. 26 years ago, the world was a different place. Being gay was not discussed. I didn't quite understand my world now and what was going on. I was full of questions with no one to talk to. What was right? What was wrong? Why is everybody so upset? Why was I being left in charge of my little sister? Why was my dad gone now, spending time with his new friend? The breaking point for everyone was one morning I was left to get my little sister ready for school. Dad hadn't been home in a few days. It was raining and cold outside. I didn't know if I should put a raincoat on her because then she would be cold, or if I should put a winter coat on her because then she would get wet. So I called my mom crying because I really didn't know what to do. Her first question was, "Well, where's your dad?" Again, I don't know. Everyone started putting the pieces together, and Mom came to rescue Ellen and I the very next day. We packed our bags and went to start a new life with her. I was now a little girl again and not a parent. Now my life was perfect. It didn't take very long for my perfect little life as a child to end. It didn't take long for my stepfather to take interest in me. The very first time he asked me to sit on his lap, he began to touch me and told me that boys would want to do this to me one day. I immediately froze. He instructed me never to tell my mom. Again, I was left with another secret, with no one to tell, no one to hear my cries. It happened over and over again, and he required me to make frequent trips with him to the store, to Sports World, Skyview. The very last time was a driving lesson in the woods. Afterwards, it hurt to walk. That Sunday, I couldn't take it anymore. I had to find a way to make it stop. I waited until after Sunday school when everyone had left, with my head bowed, and I told my teacher. He called the pastor and we went to tell my mom. During the silence that followed, I knew my mom was finally gonna come to the rescue and make this all stop. The pastor left, and she started to yell and scream, "You're lying!" I retreated to my room, and then he came home. Everyone was mad at me, yelling, "You're a liar, you're making things up." I physically get sick, and I run. I run out the door and down the path. I run, and I run. When they come look for me, I lay in a ditch beside the road. I was not going back. I made it to a neighbor's house and asked to call the pastor. He came and they called social services and placed me in foster care. The nightmare was finally over, and I no longer lived in constant fear.